Hey everyone, welcome back. Jojo here. What's going on?
Shots fire. Yo, yo!
We are quickly getting to the BTS also. We couldn't wait. So we're just doing it right away. Let's get into it. The magical journey of Ye Dunya. One.
Ready.
Ready?
Yes.
One, two, three, play.
Coke Studio, Season 14.
Tough balance for us to figure out, being in a show like Coke Studio and us being a rock band mainly. Us wajah se we were struggling ke yaar balance kya hai, what's this midpoint jahan par Coke Studio pe ek band aa raha hai, sound compromise bhi now at the same time wo Coke Studio ki respect mera with the legacy that they've been doing for like 14 years.
हर गाने का मकसद किसी ना किसी इमोशन को इवोक करे, हर गाने का, कोई गाना ऐसे नहीं हो सकता.
The song, what it has done for the band is that it's sort of unlocked this whole other spectrum and a whole other way of being a rock band.
मेरा तो इसके अंदर सारा शौक पूरा हो रहा है, क्योंकि मुझे इस बेस के सैंपल्स को इलेक्ट्रॉनिक और अकूस्टिक बेस को इस टाइप के मिक्स करके ना बजाने का बड़ा शौक है.
इसमें उस तरह से रॉक एलिमेंट यूज नहीं हो रहे जो हम लाइक करते आ रहे हैं.
आज जुल्फी भाई की खुशी देख के अपने ख्याल में 99% हमने उन्हें वो कर दिया कि आज अच्छी नींद आएगी.
This song is probably the best example of what a rock band can do with their soundscape. I mean, we haven't used such distortions in any of our songs.
Yeah. Even main the concert wali vibe mein bhi dekho na, ek moment create hua jiske andar he's alone in solitude, being karakaram, jis tarah alvida hai jaise sare gaane. Us solitude mein jaane ke baad wo jo point aata hai na, duniya, gaane ka naam bhi ye duniya hai, us pe jo stress aata hai.
Obviously, Adnan Dhool was part of the team while writing the lyrics. So I was like, yaar ye jams aur ye sab chal raha hai, ek bada hectic ek cycle bani hui hai. He came up with the idea ki yaar waise ye idea ho sakta hai ki duniya rukti nahi hai, you know. Usi waqt hamara na wo light bulb moment hone ka, yaar isko jo hai bhag ke guitar leke aao, kyunki hamari melody pehle bani hui thi.
Kya hal bro?
Haan ji
fit ho?
Bilkul fit. Aap kaise hain?
Zabardast.
Aa gaye aap.
Rap aur rock ka ek बड़ा आई थिंक एक क्लोज रिलेशनशिप है विद द अग्रेशन, विद द मैसेज पुटिंग आउट, द एटीट्यूड. तो वो एक बड़ा अच्छा ब्लेंड
है. चेहरे बदलते जाएंगे, दुनिया चलती जाएगी, ये रुकती है कहाँ किसी के लिए. तो आई थिंक ये कोई भी अगर पहली बारी में सुनेगा ना, तो वो इसको बहुत फील करेगा और इसे रिलेट करेगा, बिकॉज एट द एंड ऑफ द डे वी आर ऑल लिविंग इन द सेम वर्ल्ड. जब मैंने लिखना शुरू किया था, ऑब्वियसली एक क्रिएटिव फ्रीडम मुझे मिला फ्रॉम जुल्फी भाई, फ्रॉम द बैंड. तो फिर मैंने भी अपने दिल से जो आ रहा था, फील आ रही थी, वो लिखा एंड एवरीबडी लाइक्ड इट.
Everyone is putting their 100, I would say 200%.
बड़ा मजा आया बैंड को बजाके. I hope के आगे भी मौका मिलता रहे.
You feel like you're the right mix for the song, huh?
Yeah, I think I'm blending in. बाकी तो I think boys बेहतर बताएंगे.
Boys ने तो तालियां पीट
दी. Boys ने तो.
Boys played very well.
वो certificate पकड़ा दिया. बहुत आला यार मजा. बहुत आला.
Trying to fit in.
Thank you.
Hey, assalamu alaikum everybody. My name is Ishan Parvez. I'm the director for this track. We sort of set up this whole place over here, which has a very industrial outlook, and this has been initiated by the awesome Haris, Haris Khatri.
Industrial is the word.
He came up with this idea for scar folding to actually create depth as well. And obviously, you know, the idea is that you want to create depth in a set, right? So I think that's super cool, man. But everyone is praising you, man.
Thank you.
It showcases the fact that, you know, we live in a digital age as well, and everything is evolving, right? So hence there's glitch amongst all of us.
कैसा लग रहा है सेट कैसा लग रहा है तुम्हें
यार बहुत आला है अभी तो रेडी हो रहा है लाइट्स भी हो रही है
बट
आई थिंक लुक्स वेरी सिक
शाही वार्डरोब के लिए आए हो
यस
करा करो आई बीन सेइंग इट रॉन्ग
हाँ मिस तो मैं कर रहा हूँ बट ही इज विद अस इन स्पिरिट्स अभी सो रहा है वो घर पे
जबरदस्त लग रहा है
आ गया क्यूट
रॉक स्टार
ये क्या भाई किसी को चाहिए ऑडियो टीम लेकिन मेरी डक टेप भी इधर लगेगा एक
Yeah, Faris, I think he's a wonderful writer. Uski timing, uske flows, you know, it's very on point. Uska music jitna ek hota hai na fun loving sa uska music hai, wo asal mein bhi banda bilkul aisa hi hai. So, he's a very jolly kind of a guy. So, kafi acha experience raha uske. Too direct.
direct.
फारिस का जो मुझे सबसे फेवरेट इसके अंदर लगा है कि मेरे लव्स मेडिसिनल समझ रहे हैं तो ये बहुत डीप बात
है
चिल करेंगे हम बात ये हो जाएगा
यार माइक माइक नहीं है मेरे पास और बस कर यार
शेरी मोमेंट ऑफ ट्रूथ
ओ यस
एंड इट्स वॉइस
सबसे अच्छा पता क्या है सब ना और द लॉस ऑफ वर्ड्स सब प्रो है अपनी चीज
में यस
बिलावल के अलावा वो ब्रो है
मैं तो दोनों बॉयज का फैन हूँ तलहा अंजुम और फारिस शफी वही हमारे गानों में आ गए तो वो एक जरा अभी तक यकीन नहीं आ रहा और वो लेकिन मिल के इतना अच्छा कंट्रास्ट दोनों की बनी है कि वो बस गाना खत्म होता है तो हम जागते हैं यार अच्छा नाइस हो गया काम गुड सीन हो गया
मैं वही चीज़ आगे लेके जा रहा हूँ जो शेरी भाई ने कही है थिंग्स कुड चेंज पीपल कुड चेंज लेकिन उसका ये मतलब नहीं है कि आप अपनी एनर्जी ऑफ कर लो सो यू हैव टू यू नो बी इन द सेम एलिमेंट यू हैव टू स्टे इन योर एलिमेंट यू नो कीप दैट एनर्जी और यही मेरा एक थॉट प्रोसेस था इसके पीछे व्हेन आई वाज राइटिंग इट
म्यूजिक इज समथिंग दैट ऑलवेज टेक टाइम पाथवे है उसको पेशेंटली गुजारें इतना भी अगर है ना आपके अंदर टैलेंट या कुछ भी वट एवर इट इज़ आप पहुँचोगे जगह मतलब देर इज़ नो डाउट कि आपकी मेहनत ज़ाया नहीं जाएगी ये तो प्रूवन है
خدا کبھی آپ کو غم نہیں دکھایا نہ دکھایا کسی کے بھی لیے کسی کے بھی
ہر گانے کے اینڈ میں کلک جیسے آف ہوتا ہے کورس بجا رہے ہم بار بار کو دیکھو
پسینے کے لیے
He's trying to impress everyone so he can get like a final chorus in, you know. Yeah. Hopefully he can make it happen. You can get him a chorus where he just sings. Faris, I'm rooting for you, bro.
I think we have 5-6 takes. And because we're recording too, it's the same thing. Because in the mics, otherwise, our brother is still singing.
Bro, is it the last take?
Hopefully, man.
Everything went fine. Couple of delays, but that's always happens. And yaar, rock star of the day, Asad Raza.
Thank you.
International renowned DP. Turkish boy. And an amazing AD, I might add.
Wonderful
Ronin operator who keeps everyone alive. इसी की वजह से सारे मूवमेंट जो आप देखेंगे इसी की वजह से
ओके सीजन 14 का मेरा लास्ट शूट है अब वापस घर मुझे उससे ज्यादा टेंशन वापस यहाँ आने की जो है ना ऑडियो टीम में ये शर्ट पहनने की
ऑडियो टीम
क्या लग रहे हैं आप
जावेद साहब इन और स्टोरी माशाल्लाह क्या बात है
द वेटरन
जिंदगी जा
आमीन
यार एक मेरे साथ यार विद द स्टार ऑल द स्टारडम इज ऑलमोस्ट ओवर
Damn. See, you appreciate the song so much more with the BTS, right? Yes. And like,
it's getting complete now.
Yeah. And like Zulfi said, everybody is a pro at what they do. And when all the pros got together, the sound that came out of it, man, not just the band and the two rappers, but even the orchestra and like everyone on set, the video team, the video crew, everyone, the set. What a beautiful set, by the way. We're going to talk about the set in the reaction, but
we did. I mean, I spoke a little bit about it. Yeah, that it's very AI kind of a set, like especially with the panels which they had put, which even right now when they were talking about it, actually looked very futuristic, you know, especially
the graphics that were
happening,
that whole thing, right?
Yeah.
It was very Star Trek, very live long and prosper types. Also, I get with the song, na, ye duniya rukti nahi hai kisi ke liye. It's moving ahead. That got captured.
My personal favorites are in BTS when every time they talk about the origin of how the song came to be. Before they actually picked up the guitars. Where did the thought come from? That is now I'm realizing over the BTSs that like that's becoming a bit of a favorite moment for me. Like I get actually excited like the moment they're talking about it. And
because that like he said, no, the song narrative and the this thing, everything is a starting point from there where the thought originated.
Yep.
And here it was like ye duniya rukegi nahi kisi ke liye, you have to flow with the world as it is and find your own.
It was such a boys club. Like there were so many moments which when they were saying that, you know, jab beach mein ho raha tha and when unhone kaha ke AC wagera band tha and garmi lag rahi hai lekin aapka constantly chal raha, you know, that moment I can relate with that because like it's true when the mics are on and like for hours and hours and aap ek ek take ke baad take de rahe ho and AC can't come on, you're melting but you have to look really good on camera in that moment, like that I could actually see all of them going through it and yet to maintain calmness and yet to, you know, look good and feel good, and all of them looked phenomenal. And like just the presentation was point on. Bahut
acha tha. So, you know, Sherry was looking like a rock star. He was saying, now I have to get back into the audio team clothes after this one. This is a rock star, which is ended with this song.
That's true.
But man, like I was saying, we've seen him in so many BTSs as part of the audio team. And then to see him in that avatar of that lead vocalist and, you know, Correct. Absolute rock star is the only word that comes to mind. The talent in this guy, his voice, and just like what he can do. But what was more interesting for me in this particular BTS was how the band was like, okay, as a band with its own sound, how do we bring our musicality to the table of Coke Studio and merge with what else is going on in the song. So for them to kind of mold themselves into what was required was very interesting to see. And each band member had something to say about that, you know?
Correct. So, and they were also real. Jo ho raha tha, literally, they were like mirrors to the set. You know, जो वहां पे घट रहा था वो BTS के अंदर उन्होंने actually literally बोल दिया. So I liked what they spoke about Farah Shafi also, like the reality of the situation or what was going on. And just Zulfi seemed so at ease. I think in most other BTSs where we've seen, he's constantly with it and he's focused. But यहाँ पे for some reason, I think he seemed a little more relaxed, but yet enjoying the whole thing. Maybe it's because he was surrounded by like musicians, or I think normally also that is the case. I don't know what the scene was, but
maybe
like
it was
over
just
here,
that
to me,
Sherry's there, he's handling it. It's
totally possible. Right? He seemed like very, and how that there was that one bite where one of the band members said, no, that just unko itna khush dekh ke hi 100% hamare liye complete ho gaya. So, which was, it's beautiful. That just shows how together everyone is and how that one unit becomes like such a family and how they're all creating and doing such good work. And it's so cute. I think when Coke Studio 14 was finished, little crying will happen, even from us, I think.
From us, for sure. For sure, imagine them. They'll be to buckets only, they'll be crying. Anju.
Aakhri gaana aane wala ka pehle bata dena, main Jojo ko pehle buckets and buckets of like, you know, pull out tissues bhej dungi. She'll require it.
Anju was very sweet. He seems, you know, like Anju.
He's trying to fit in.
Yeah, but also like, okay, so now we've like covered so much of Youngstunners and Anjum and all that, and we know how like hard they can go in their songs and their verses and things like that. Yeah. Here it seemed like a completely different Talha, you know? It seemed like a chill guy, like very humble and like trying to get it. He's like, how do I fit into the band? He's like, I'm vibing with the music. I think I fit into it. And this is how I wrote from this thought, my verse, and I think it works. And you know, it was very like that. And then it was also when they asked him, are you missing the other Talha? He's like, yes. So that was nice because it's not very often that
we would have wondered. So it's a good thing that they asked him. And, like, you
because
know,
he's done solos without Eunice, but it's not on a big stage like a Coke Studio stage that they've appeared separate. Even in the past, I think they are Pepsi tracks or Coke, whatever. They've done all these things, but they've done them together. So anyway, whatever. That was cute. It was nice to see him in this sort of very chill avatar. So yay for the BTS team. We love it. What else? So it was something else. Did you notice the orchestra? Did you notice the violinist at the end, Zulfi was talking to him?
When he was talking to him. I thought you meant like, did some visuals come from the song? I didn't.
There was a cello player sitting there.
Correct. I saw. But yeah. So, I think I'll have to watch the video again to see ki video mein kahan pe the. But definitely, wo jab unse baat kar rahe the end mein, that I saw. Which is amazing.
And also, I feel
and
like,
I remember him from a lot of other seasons of Coke Studio. Yeah. You know, when we've seen. Yeah. Yeah.
He's been around for the longest time and quite the veteran. This I feel like when he said na hum iske baad chill karenge, maybe there's a collab coming. Just say. Faris and Anjum. He said na hum baad mein chill. You don't think so?
Arre wo to aise wala chill, but I don't know.
Listen, whenever anyone chills in the hip hop scene, it's like how they're collabing. So I'm just throwing in my little
That's
masala.
True.
It's okay. Whether it happens or not, it's okay. So all that aside, I'm gonna loop this song. Man.
Aur kuch nahi to ek live to nikal hi aayega aur kya?
Yeah. I have to just say it because it's on my mind. For me, Sherry's vocals were the best thing about this song. Yes. I'm just saying.
Yes.
So
I second you on that. Ditto.
Okay. Yay. So yes. On that note, loved it. Thank you so much, Coke Studio, for the magic. As always, please don't end this season. Just keep it going forever and ever. That's all. And take care of yourselves. We'll see you. Hey everyone, we are back. This is the same BTS of Ye Dunya, but we are recording on a different day because we recorded that one right after we heard the song. And then somebody said that the band also shared their own BTS on their own channel. So please react to that as well. So I thought I can't react to two BTSs in two separate videos. So I'm just combining the two into one video. So these are being recorded days apart from each other. So
yeah.
So yes. What happened that day is we reacted to Ye Dunya, our minds were blown, and then immediately after that we reacted to the BTS as well. Ek hi session, yeah. Ek hi sitting mein. So there were a lot of things that day that I feel were, you know, we were just too like mind blown by the song.
Enamored.
Yeah. So now
but
that
which is true also.
It's absolutely. And if I mean, if you're not blown away by that track, then something is wrong with you. So I'll just say. Basically now that we've had some days to process it and I've heard it multiple times, I feel like maybe we'll have something to add to what we've already
I'm just discussed. Happy to listen to it again. I'm more than happy to. Let's
more than happy
do
to
it.
See more BTS footage. Yeah. Exactly. Chalo, yeah. Let's do it. BTS of Ye Dunya made by the wonderful South Asian Saeen. Okay, let's do it. 1, 2, 3, play.
पूजा सीमेंट वालों का शीशा लगवाया क्योंकि वो चलता बहुत है
यार,
ये हमारा स्ट्रिंग सेक्शन है, बड़े बड़े लेजेंड्स इस ग्रुप में बैठे हुए हैं
यार, मैं मीडिया पर्सन हूँ करेक्ट, ये ना मीडिया ठीक है,
आपने मीडिया को
बुलाया जाता है, मैं इन्हीं का बंदा हूँ
किस तरह का गाना है जरा बताएं हमें
यार, बड़ा मिक्स है, मतलब कार्यक्रम टाइप भी है और एट द सेम टाइम एक नई डायमेंशन है गाना, सो आई थिंक स्नाइपर है यहाँ पे मिस्टर शेरी फटक शेरी का पिंजरा और यहाँ पे अनान खड़ा है हमारा बेखुदी के सोलो वाला लड़का अनान Very interesting combo between the rap artist and the grungier side of what we do. बड़े बड़े लेजेंड्स इस ग्रुप में बैठे हुए हैं जिन्होंने लंबी मैं जब पैदा भी नहीं हुआ था जब से प्ले कर रहा हूँ तो हमारे लिए बड़े ऑनर की बात है यार कि इतने बड़े बड़े प्लेयर्स हमारे साथ परफॉर्म कर रहे हैं तो
कोक स्टूडियो वाले चाचा बैठे हैं ना बीच में आप एक्साइटेड हैं इस गाने के लिए
बहुत ज़्यादा बहुत पूरे कोक स्टूडियो से एक्साइटेड पूरे सीजन से
यार आपसे जितना पूछा जाए उतना बताए इस गाने
फिर तुम चाह रहे हो वीडियो से फिर हमारी कोई आए
आपसे जितना पूछा जाए कितना याद हो गया
ये रह गया बस
थोड़ा सा रह गया वो ये याद कर रहा है
इस तरह का जो हम गाना कर रहे हैं ये मेरा ख्याल है हम लोग पहली दफ़ा ही कर रहे हैं कि इलेक्ट्रॉनिक इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स हमने इन्फ्यूज़ किए हैं बेस मैं पहली दफ़ा बजा रहा हूँ सिंथ हमेशा से शौक था मुझे तो इसमें हमने इम्प्लीमेंट किया है
अब पोर्शंस हैं हर
जगह गाने के. There are these high points and these low points. So वो I think वो dynamic एक ride की तरह चलता है. So I think बड़ा मज़े का एक balance बना. We're pretty excited.
कल का जो पार्ट है वो उसमें थोड़ा मसला कह रहा है मगर
शहर बदलते रहे हम इसी शहर में चलते रहे.
कर दो ऐसे ही कर दो.
घर था वीरान मेरा और हम अकेले ही चलते रहे.
तो तेरी
हाँ ये जो पार्ट है ना जब ये खत्म होता है
मेरे बाल.
Love yourself, bro. Love yourself.
जो हमने experimentations की हैं इस गाने के अंदर तो वो आपको upcoming album में भी दिखेगी क्योंकि हमारे बहुत सारी चीज़ें unlock हो चुकी हैं और गाने में हमारे साथ फारिस और तला ज़बरदस्त काम कर रहे हैं. मज़ा आ जाता है. आप गाना अभी सुनेंगे तो आपको पता लगेगा.
सब कुछ मैं कह दूं दिल में है क्या. सब कुछ मैं कह दूं बेवजह.
चेहरे बदलते रहे हम इसी शहर में चलते रहे. ये चेहरे बदलते रहे हम इसी शहर में चलते रहे.
रिहर्सल में ऐसे करते हैं. वाओ दिस ऑलमोस्ट फेल्ट लाइक वॉचिंग द एंटायर सॉन्ग अगेन विद लाइक यू नो विद जस्ट लाइक ऑल द एलिमेंट्स सेपरेटेड आउट एंड देन पुट टुगेदर. लाइक ओके वाओ एंड आई आल्सो काइंड ऑफ रियली रियली admire the fact that they went into such detail explaining the BTS in this, you know, the whole musical sides to it. And when they were talking about it, how this is such a different feel to that BTS that we saw. Yeah. Because usme it was more about the overall impact and the whole Coke studio feel of it. Here, it's about the music, the performers and the artists, which is like, it's got its own delicious. I know, you know, last time I think ek BTS mein hi jab suna, that's when we realized. Yeah. Hai na? You, I'm sure even you realized.
I realized, and but meaning, I forgot how he was saying it. Now I like.
But meaning is so beautiful. Mm. Do your karma. Kara karam. Like, you know, that's in Karakaram, like Karakaram. Like, that's where it makes sense to me suddenly. And I'm like, achha, matlab ye. Ye toh pehle samajh hi nahi aaya tha.
Really interesting. My God, I liked it. First of all, they're so funny, all of them.
Yeah, yeah. And the whole band ka chemistry, the feel, the way all of them are talking to each other, that's so much more. Like, you get to hear and know so much more of what is happening, no?
Bilawal is hilarious. Yeah, and
Sherry Khattak is just too much.
Did you see the orchestra and the string?
Yeah, after that day itself, I went and I immediately saw and I was like, of course I saw it. How could I, like, you know, there was so much going on that I think that time the senses were so full of the song. And yeah, in a lot of ways, Sherry Khattak. And in a lot of ways, like just the Karakaram, the band, and of course, like just everybody, like, how can we even like just go back? And
in this, Sherry, because it's just, it's like the guy is just,
I stick to what I said that day, you know, he, just listening to him, it's so mesmerizing. He kind of pulls you in, even in the rehearsal, he kind of just pulls you in and just keeps you there that you don't feel like letting go. Yeah. That's what his music does. In the BTS right now, this one, we also got the whole rap version so cleanly. Like, it almost felt like a new song to me, which also felt really good. Like, it was like a separated version. Didn't you feel that?
Yeah, it did. I was just, it was very cute how like, you know, how, like, you could see the focus that Talha has during the rehearsals. Like, he's like, focused. He's like, I don't want to miss a beat. I don't want to miss my cue. I want to get this exactly right. And then like memorizing the line, all of that. And like you said, like Sherry's voice just pulls you in. It he does that in this song right from the first like word he utters, right? Sherry. Like, right, but we said this, I think, in the reaction. As soon as he started, we were in. And then even when he's doing the low parts and then the high parts, and of course, we can't say enough about that scream at the end.
रिहर्सल में ऐसी स्क्रीम मुझे लगा ही मस्ट हैव केप्ट इट फॉर द मेन टाइम ऑफ परफॉर्मेंस के हाँ ठीक है मतलब लाइक यू नो हमेशा बट लाइक एंड ही इज हाउ डज हिज वॉइस नॉट लाइक यू नो गला खराब नहीं होता वो करने के बाद लाइक हाउ हिज वॉइस मस्ट बी यू नो सो मैलेबल एंड सो रिहर्स्ड एंड सो लाइक क्या बोलते हैं इतना रियाज किया होता है कि गला इतना खुला हुआ है दैट ही कैन डू समथिंग लाइक दैट एंड स्टिल बी लाइक ऑल गुड वन सेकंड लेटर व्हाट हाउ
Also, we missed, you know what else we missed? We missed Talha Anjum's last few lines. He had another like mini verse at the end. So I'm just looking at the lyrics here because I really, you know, every line from his verse was a quotable quote, like somebody commented. And I agree because the way this guy writes, he really just like, he took the essence of the song and just made it his own and took it to another level with his lines, you know? And I mean,
did you feel that, you know, how normally there is a on camera persona or like, you know, gaano ke andar jo ek persona dikhta hai versus jab aap behind the scenes jaate ho, not necessarily that the two people will match, right? But the sensitivity and the depth that we listen to in Tala's songs always here, when BTS ke andar, there are moments when you captured him trying to like figure the whole thing out. He's exactly like that. You know, he didn't seem like a different person. He actually felt like a really sensitive person who's very, very serious about his craft and how he was going in depth into it. Like, you know, that pain was showing on his face. The pain that we usually hear in his voice via his songs. And, you know, I don't know how to express it. It's that good pain the when somebody's gone through stuff. It's not a crying wala pain. It is the depth wala pain. And that depth showed through in his persona so entirely. To me, that was like, oh, wow, that's interesting. Because, you know, we know how young he is and we normally talk about how much, like, you know, jab aap gaana gaate ho ya aap gaana bana rahe ho, it could be like a switch on personality and then in your real life, you could be a different person. But here, he seems like the same person, which to me, like, it was good.
You mean his old soulness? I feel like he's an old soul and his old soulness comes out in these BTS. Like, you see how he's focused on the craft exactly and he's just a thinker, you know? He's a thinker. Yeah. So here are the lines. I think this is where it starts. Sab kuch main keh dun, chehre badalte rahe, hum isi shahar mein chalte. Sab kuch main keh dun, ghar tha veera mera aur hum akele hi chalte rahe. Dhale shaam aur din chadhe, chalo roshni ke sam chale. Apni zaat pe yakin mera, azaim hi mujhe azim kare. Hukim hai kalam alil ke liye, kehne ko tere rafiq to hai, par phir bhi peet piche kyun, ye harif bane ajeeb ye. So I think I know these words' ka meanings from the context. Mm. but let me still pull it up because so many words.
Because context mein samajh aaya, but the context could be, you know, sometimes words change the context entirely. So upar upar se lagta hai ki kuch aur hai, but actually when you go into meaning, wo badal jata hai. Every second word over here was like, wait, what?
Yeah. What? Dare shaam aur din chade, chalo roshni ke sam chale, simt chale, direction, okay? Apni zaat pe yakin mera, azaim hi mujhe azim kare. Azaim is goals. Hi mujhe azim kare, great kare.
Oh, nice. Mm.
Hakim likha hai idhar. Hakim hai kalam alil ke liye. Hakim is doctor, alil is patient. Doctor, Hakim hai kalam alil ke liye. Kehne ko tere rafiq to hai, rafiq is friend. Kehne ko tere friend to hai, par phir bhi peet piche kyun ye harif bane, harif is enemy. Ajeeb ye. So, dude, man, this guy.
I'm sorry. This song just leaves you like that.
Multiply 20,000 fold.
This song leaves you speechless. So yeah. It is, I know time. Why we're feeling, I'm feeling it again. You know, that blankness, that spaced out feeling. Ye gana sunte hi ho jata hai. What to do? Because it pushes you into thought. So if thought hoga, to fir aap chupi rahoge na. I'm again feeling like that.
His lines, man, even the previous verse which we went through already in the reaction, the more time I spent listening to the song, the more I was like, man, this is just so, like, after first listen you can only take in that much, right? But this is just, I don't want to use words like masterpiece or whatever, legendary, you know? I think those words are like, their meaning is diluted now because they're overused, but this song is in a different like league. That's all. I'm not going to say any more than that.
This song just overall has a very personal feel to it. You know, it's almost like the more you listen to it, the reason it pushes you into those spaces is because you feel like the song is sitting right next to your heart and kind of speaking its pain to you. And you know, kuch gaane hote hain, wo aap dur se sunte ho. Kuch gaane hote hain, aap bilkul yahan se sunte ho. Ye gaana wo wala hai. So it's just like, yeah, it just puts you in a spiral every time, which is just amazing.
Tere badalte jayenge, chalti jayegi. Ye dunya rukti hai kahan, kisi ke bhi liye. Relatable for every person on the planet. So yay, thank you Coke Studio, thank you Karakaram, thank you Dada Arjun, Farish Shafi, everyone involved with this song. It's a good time to be alive, that's all I'll say. And yeah, hope you enjoyed this double BTS special. Hit me up in my DMs for any more recommendations. Miss Bola is also on Insta. That's her handle. Do support this channel. It really helps. And take care of yourselves. Enjoy the song. We'll see you in the next one. Live long and prosper.